trying to appear relaxed, I wafted casually through the side gate to greet them. Their Louis Vuitton bags were spirited away to their suites while Joan and Percy made appropriate remarks about the house and garden. "You must take us as you find us," I sighed. I barely had time to put the hoover around. "Dog," stated Joan as she passed a passive-looking Valerie on the way to the lounge. "Very well behaved. Don't you have two?" "Yes, Albert is around somewhere," I replied, raising my voice to cover the ominous whimpering from the kitchen. We chatted as we tucked into our sandwiches with the crusts cut off. But after a few minutes, we were interrupted by Albert rushing into the room. He'd escaped and was anxious to greet the visitors. "Ah, Albert's here," I said nervously. "He's quite young." Albert gave Percy a cursory sniff that made a beeline for Joan. "Ugh," exclaimed Joan. Albert jumped on the sofa and pressed himself to her side, tail thumping with friendly delight as he gazed lovingly up at her. "This always happens," said Joan, shaking her head. "I'm nervous of dogs, but they always want to be my best friend." "He definitely likes you." This is my American accent. "He definitely likes you." "Very much," declared Percy, raising his eyebrows. I followed his line of vision, and there it was. Albert was sporting a huge pink erection. I thought it best to lure Albert back to the kitchen with a biscuit before he ejaculated over the victorious song. "It can't help it," I explained. "You're a very charismatic woman."